Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in fabulous Philippines. Praise the living God, brothers and sisters. I'm so excited because the Lord gave me an awesome word and a vision. I don't have the word written in front of me because actually I'd given the word as I wrote to two different people. It's a culmination of the things, brothers and sisters, that the Lord's been showing me for 15 years. So it's not something new. But the Lord always does according to His word. It's line upon line, precept upon precept, here a little, there a little, from glory to glory. God builds, you know, in our walk with Him. He builds in the revelation. Even the Bible itself is given in revelation. In other words, God added to the word through every generation and increased it until finally, of course, the culmination was the Lord Jesus Christ coming to earth and dying on the cross. And then the culmination of that is His return. So, brothers and sisters, I'm so excited because the Lord gave me what He's already been showing me, but He showed me in a totally different way, brothers and sisters, totally different way, what I've been talking about. And so it's kind of like been like a double-minded thing that we would have a falling away in the church, as the Bible says, and then a revival for the true bride, and yet it's time for the rapture, yet it's time for the tribulation. So all those things are merging and coming together, brothers and sisters. So I want to just give an overview of what the Lord showed me right now in a vision just a few, today, an hour or 30 minutes ago, and then and just explain it all to you and just in a nutshell, you know. So here's the things that the Lord had showed me. Revival, there's going to be a quick revival for the bride. God is going to purify His bride. And so there's people that's asked me, and I've answered them. This is from the Lord. The one of the biggest questions I get from Christians is an answer to Luke 21:36. And like I say, do not let people that don't believe in the pre-tribulation rapture, not people that believe in the rapture, pre-tribulation rapture, not mid-trib, post-trib, all that. The rapture is imminent. If it's mid-trib or post-trib, then you can calculate when it's going to be. So there's no discussion about that. We're talking pre-trib rapture. Don't let anybody get you off and get into all these tangents and stuff. God has people assigned to teach those things and get into it with people. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter what anybody thinks. The Lord's going to, the Bible says that let everybody be still in the presence of the Lord. The Lord's going to shut everybody's mouth, you know. God's going to give them hush puppies, you know. And hush puppies were invented by somebody who gave them to their dog because their dog kept barking. So they invented hush puppies, which is something that's popular here in the southeastern part of the United States. Hush puppies, they call them. And it was to hush the dog up. And so God's going to give the world hush puppies. How about that for a slogan? God's going to give the world hush puppies when He takes His bride. Now, the Lord has been talking to me, and I made videos, and people ask me, well, is it going to be revival or rapture? There's going to be a quick revival, brothers and sisters, and then the rapture. It could be days, it could be weeks, it could be months. I don't know how many days, weeks, months. But it's coming. The Lord's been talking to me about that for years. 15 years the Lord has been speaking to me about that and showing me. And at the same time, He's been showing me, you know, it's going to be the rapture, it's going to be the tribulation and all those things. And so, brothers and sisters, this is the vision that I had. And when people ask me, let me get back to what I was saying, Luke 21:36. People ask me, you know, what can I do to be kind of worthy to escape these things? And Jesus was talking about the tribulation. At the end of that, Luke 21:36, He said, therefore, you know, pray ye always that you be counted worthy to escape these things and stand before the Son of Man. He didn't say one sinner's prayer. He said, pray always. Always, not one time, always that you be counted worthy to escape these things. I made videos about that. And there's people that just want to hear a vision, just want to hear a dream. It doesn't do you any good to hear dreams and visions if you don't have the wisdom and have an ear to hear what the Spirit is saying to the church through those dreams and visions. It doesn't do you any good if you don't have the wisdom to understand what God's saying. Because when you miss it, if you don't have an ear to hear. That's why the Lord would use me to explain the dream or vision, not like just get on there and make a, you know, speak the dream and then boom, that's it, and just let you put it to your own private interpretation. God doesn't operate that. If you do, you're going to miss it. You're going to miss what the Spirit is saying to the church. So, brothers and sisters, the short answer, how do you be counted worthy? The number one question I get asked is to do like Enoch did. I made a video several years ago about it that the Lord told me. Enoch was raptured. He's the type of the church. He was a Gentile. People say, see, a lot of people don't even know that there were no Hebrews until you got Abraham. And then Abraham's grandson was Jacob. His name was changed to Israel. There were no Israelites until the children of Israel, Jacob. And then there were no Jews until Judah, the children of Judah, one of the sons of Isaac, of Jacob, who was the son of Isaac, who was the son of Abraham. So when he called, you know, Enoch was certainly not a Jew. He was a Gentile. There were no Jews at that time. There was no Israel. God had not made that covenant till Abraham. God made the Abrahamic covenant many, you know, several generations after Enoch. So Enoch is a type of the church. What did Enoch do? It tells us in Genesis. He walked with God and he was no more. Now, when I started the YouTube ministry before that, 2009, the Lord spoke to me, study Enoch and the book of Enoch. But I'm saying to you, you don't even need to read the book of Enoch, because that's, unless you're going to be here for the tribulation, that's what's happening in the tribulation. About the fallen angels and all that stuff coming back, the Nephilim, the giants and all that stuff. But for us, we just need to study what's written about Enoch in the King James Bible or any version that's trying to follow the original text from Genesis chapter, in there about the flood 5 and 6 and all those things. And what does it say? It says, Enoch walked with God and he was no more, because God took him. So if you want to be counted worthy to escape the tribulation, you want to be raptured, I'm going into pre-tribulation rapture, and those who are counted worthy going to go by faith, by grace through faith, we're going. And don't let anybody steal your crown. It says don't let anybody steal your crown. But there's a crown for those who love his appearing. Don't let anybody steal that crown from you. Put your faith and trust that the Lord is coming for his bride. The Lord Jesus Christ is not a wife beater. He's coming for us. For who? Those that are walking with him, like Enoch. Enoch walked with God and he was no more. Walk with God and you'll be no more. You just won't be here. You'll just be no more. When the rapture happens, it'll just... You are no more. It is going to be boom in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye. People's just going to say, hey, you're gone. All the people talking about, oh, they saw you going up. No. In the moment, in the twinkling of an eye. That's Jack Van Impe says it is. You know, Dr. Jack Van Impe is 1/258th of a second, whatever it takes to blink your eye. People ain't going to know what happened. They ain't going to see you going up. You're going to be gone. You're going to be gone in a moment, in a twinkling of an eye. Hallelujah. Those who walk with God, we will be no more. Say, where's brother so-and-so? We don't know. He's just no more. He's gone. He's gone with the wind. Hallelujah. Be gone with the wind. Hallelujah. Praise God. God's going to give them hush puppies. He's going to hush their mouth. All these false prophets on YouTube spouting that there's no rapture and all this kind of stuff. And who knows how many thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of people are following them with a different gospel, saying that Jesus is a wife beater. Jesus is going to beat his betrothed bride and then come back and marry her. Nonsense. Those who will be beat with many stripes are those who are not walking with the Lord, those who are not found worthy. Those are part of the lukewarm nominal church. That means in name only. Part of Christendom, but not a part of the bride, not a part of the church. Don't let anybody drag you into a debate about who's the bride. The Bible tells us that New Jerusalem is the bride of Christ also, and then metaphorically representing the church being united with the Lord. You think the Lord's going to marry a city? Do you marry a city? No. How do we become? And there's tons of Bible verses. It talks about Christ loved the church as a man should love his wife, so Christ loved the church. They're there in Ephesians. Many, many Bible verses. It's a mystery, it says. Jesus is the head, we're the body. When a man and woman, they become one flesh, the wife is the body of the man. As Paul says, you can't hate your own flesh. That's why you're nice to your wife, because you hate your wife, you hate your own flesh, the Bible tells us. The two become one flesh. So the woman's body and the man's body are one, literally and spiritually and figuratively. They're one and one head. Anything with two heads is a freak, a beast. Something with one head is from God, and that is the man. It's supposed to be the head of his family. That's a whole other message. But the vision that I just had, I see the Lord, you know, I'm a preacher at heart, brothers and sisters, and a pastor. So I got to pastor a little bit. And now I want to tell you the vision that I had today. Culmination of all the things the Lord's been showing me over 15 years. I saw the Lord Jesus Christ with a crown and a beautiful white robe. And I was there, brothers and sisters, and I saw there was a woman that was the bride. It was the church, the true church. The bride of Christ was there, and I was there too. And the Lord had the scroll. Now the scroll he had in his hand, brothers and sisters, is the title deed to this earth. In that scroll is the same one that's from Revelation, where he opens the seals of the book. Now, he had that scroll rolled up in his hand. The Lord Jesus Christ was standing in the midst of the throne holding that scroll. It's like you see in Revelation, chapter 4 and 5, along in there. And the Lord had that scroll, and he took and turned to me, brothers and sisters, and that scroll had, you know, these wooden, like a rolling pin. Speaking of husbands and wives, you know, it was like a rolling pin, you know, but it was a scroll, like a Torah scroll, and on the end were these wooden pieces, you know, like handles that you would hold. And the Lord turned to me, and he touched me on top of the head with that scroll, brothers and sisters. And then the fire of God just fell on me. It was liquid gold. And then the Lord turned. Now listen to me. The Lord turned and he took that scroll and he touched the head of the bride. And the bride was totally baptized in a golden river, a river of liquid gold over the bride. And then the bride was no more. It became a river of liquid gold and I could not see the bride anymore. The bride was gone. There was just a river of living gold, there from that scroll, and the bride was gone. And then the Lord turned to get ready to open that scroll. He turned toward the world. He turned from the bride. I was like on this side. The bride was here on my left, which would be, you know, and then straight across was the world. And after the Lord touched the bride with that scroll and that golden river overtook her, it began to cover her and then overtake her. She was baptized. It looked like honey, but it was living gold, the Lord is telling me. It was living gold. She was consumed in that living gold, and brothers and sisters, she was no more. The only thing left there was the river of gold, liquid living gold. And then he turned to the earth and began to get ready to open up that scroll. Now, brothers and sisters, over the interpretation that the Lord gave me is he will do a mighty work that all those, I've made videos about this in the past in bits and pieces, and now the Lord has confirmed all those things to me that I've been saying in bits and pieces as he's inspired me. There will be a quick revival. Every person that will be raptured, the Lord is going to deal with them. So we all need to be dealt with and be purified because the Lord is coming for a bride without spot or blemish. He's going to purify us. How? By His Spirit. It's not by might nor by power, but by His Spirit, says the Lord. He's going to do it by His Word and by His Spirit, brothers and sisters. Coming out of that scroll, out of His Word, out of His judgments on the world, the Lord will bring His church to be no more. So you want to, tons of people ask me that. You want to be counted worthy to escape these things that's about to come on the earth? The tribulation period is soon to begin. Any time, brothers and sisters, at any time. And before that happens, the Lord is coming for a bride without spot or blemish, a bride that is walking with Him. Even as I quote the Bible verse all the time, Amos 3:3, how can two walk together except they be in agreement? And we got to walk in agreement with the Lord. And brothers and sisters, those are those out there that believe that God doesn't speak anymore. It's only from the Bible. Let me tell you something. God's message to you, to the Christendom, to the lukewarm Laodicean church is Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. Now, brothers and sisters, I used to do crusades and revivals in the Philippines for several years. Evangelism to the lost and pastors' conferences and all this. They invited me to come to it's a nationwide denomination in the Philippines. It's actually from Singapore. They've invited me to come speak at their three-day conference, and I haven't done any in several years. And the Lord spoke to me and said, go. And the Lord gave me the theme. And this is the theme for the backslidden, for those who will not repent, for those who are lukewarm people that's about to be thrown into the tribulation. This is the word of the Lord to you, Laodiceans, and to those who have a form of godliness and deny the power thereof, all you old denominational people. This is the word. Hear the word of the Lord from you. It's from Hebrews. And it says, Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. God has not changed. There's no shadow of turning in Him. In Him there is no darkness and no shadow of turning, the King James says. No matter what way inside you look at God, there is no shadow because He's all light. He's all the same. He's steadfast. His love endureth forever. Hallelujah. From to 10,000s of generations. Hallelujah. For the Lord's will shall be done. Hallelujah. Says the Lord, and no man can shut the doors that the Lord is about to open a revival on His church. There will be no high theologians trying to stop the work of God this time. Many times in the past, high theologians came in with doubt and unbelief and fear and unbelief and tried to quench the Spirit of God, as the Word tells us, quench not the Spirit of God, forbid not the speaking of tongues. And yet these children of terrors of the enemy have crept in and tried to spy out the liberty we've had in, that we have in Christ. But the Lord said, not this time, for my bride will walk with me, and then it will be no more. The bride shall be no more. Now the Lord even gave me a theme song for this move. It's a brand new song. I hadn't heard it before. And it just so happens that another brother, the Lord had given this brother the same song a few days ago. I didn't know the name of it. Then this morning, the Lord gave me the same song. Now, it's probably copyrighted. I want to try to play a little bit of it on here. I don't want my video to be messed up, so I want to play it quietly in the background. It's called Soul on Fire by Third Day. It's a new song. And the Lord wants you to keep playing this and get this down into your spirit, brothers and sisters. Get this down into your spirit. You know, let this song get in your spirit. This is what God wants us to do. Be God chasers. Let your soul be on fire. God's gonna. I'll put the link for this song below here. God wants you to hear it, to let it bless your spirit. You've got to be a God chaser. God is coming for a bride that's coming for his heart. Let me tell you something. The Lord spoke to me too right before I started making this video. He's reminding me now. This song says, God, I'm running for your heart. I want to be until I am a soul on fire. Did you know there's many of people, these denominational people, I'm talking to you. You old dead denominational people with a form of godliness who deny the power thereof. You know, and some of you, it's wives and husbands are on fire. Then the husband or wife is old lukewarm, a form of godliness, outwardly appearing, mental assented Christian, but not truly saved. And you know what the Lord told me? Just change those words. God, I'm running from your heart. Stop running from the heart of God. I'm speaking to you. I'm not going to call nobody's name out, but there's people in my mind. I'm talking to you. There's a brother who I love in the Lord who I'm talking to. And it's from the Lord. He says, you know, the song that's in your heart is not God, I'm running for your heart, but God, I'm running from your heart. Stop running from the Lord. And you know who you are. Let it be a witness in your spirit, brother. Stop running from the heart of the Lord and run to him. The name of the Lord is a strong tower, and those that run into him, they are saved. Hallelujah, the Bible says in the Psalms. Run to the Lord, not from the Lord, brother. And there's many more of you. I don't know all of you. Many more of you. You're running. God, I'm running from your heart. I just want to have a mental picture of salvation, but it's not inside my heart. I'm living for the world, and I'm going to be left behind. Now, there's a song from the Lord for you. Sometimes the Lord chastens those whom he loves. The Lord loves you. He don't want you to be left behind. That's why I spoke that. Because the Lord doesn't want you to be left behind. The Lord endures the foolishness of preaching that some might be saved. God bless you, brothers and sisters. The link will be below this video. The Lord's going to send me to bring revival. I'm going to be involved in it in the United States. I'll be back there shortly, brothers and sisters, as the Lord wills. God bless you, brothers and sisters.